So I request Mr. Nambirajan to share his views on GST. Thank you. I request our chairman and Mr. Vasant Kumar to greet him with a bouquet, please. Over to Mr. Nambirajan.
After hearing the success story, now we are going to talk about GST. For many people may not be a success, it may be painful also. We will explain in simple form what is GST and what is the implication on the animal feed sector and poultry sector. As all of you are aware, prior to July 2017, the central government levied excise duty on the taxable event of manufacture and service tax on the provision of service, and CST, central sales tax, on the sales made interstate, which was collected by the state government. Similarly, the state government levied tax on the taxable event of sale of goods. After 1/7/2017, when GST was introduced, all these taxes have been subsumed into what is called GST. In view of the federal system, state will have to levy tax and also central. Therefore, there is a central GST and state GST. And for the interstate, it is integrated GST. The taxable event is now changed to supply. Typically, for the purpose of supply definition, if you see the definition, it is wide enough to cover all transactions. Scope of supply is now all forms of supply of goods or services or both. It can be sale, transfer, barter, exchange, rental, lease, disposal. Almost every transaction is covered under. Whatever is conceivable transaction, they are all covered, and it will be for a consideration and in by a person to or in the course of. In the course of furtherance of business. It should be in the course of furtherance of business. That's very important. So the taxable event of manufacture is replaced now by taxable event of supply. Similarly, taxable event of sale is there in the form of supply now. So one impact of GST is that the manufacture, which is an event of taxing the commodity, is not there now. It has to be supplied, then only it will be, and it has to be for consideration and in furtherance of our course, in the course of business, then only it will be taxable. The question for the relevance for the animal feed and poultry sector is the supply. Even though there is a supply animal feed, there is a supply. There is an exemption. The government has power to exempt. Therefore, they have exempted animal feed. Therefore, though there is a supply, it is exempt. Similarly, for poultry sector, it is coming under. We will explain that how it is coming under the agricultural processes, and therefore there are certain services which are covered by the exemption. That we will come to that later. The next one, rate. If you can see the rate comparison in VAT, oil from oil and oil from oil seeds were exempt. They were liable to 5% tax or 6% VAT, but excise was exempt. Yet without shell, excise was exempt, but VAT was leviable. Chemical fertilizer, excise was nil rate, whereas 1% or 2% was there later on. And then animal wool, hair, etc. These are all products of the poultry, and therefore we have taken these products for the purpose of comparison of rate. Now, commodities taxed at 5% under VAT and GST are aquatic animals, frozen and processed. If you see the products of the industry, the live animals are not taxed, whereas the dead animals in the form of meat, etc., they are taxed only when they are processed other than frozen or processed other than chilled. If it is frozen, it is that also exempt. But the condition for levy of tax is that it should be used, put up in a unit container, and having a brand name. Commodities taxed at nil rate, both on VAT and as well as GST, are live animals, poultry, aquatic animals, fresh meat, feeds for cattle, poultry, and aquatic animals. Earlier also excise was also exempt, VAT was exempt, now GST is also exempt. Yet with shell, still exempt. We were talking about what is egg with shell or without shell. The egg without shell is that which is boiled and then shell is removed. That egg seems to be liable to tax now.
Which one? It's related to liquid, not a egg, without shell, it's a liquid egg.
Maybe, sir. How will you interpret? Therefore, there is a question of interpretation. That's it. Then the GST rate for meat, these are the outputs of poultry, where I have already told you meat and meat offal in the frozen as well as fresh and chilled will be chargeable to nil rate of duty, provided it is not put up in unit container and having brand name. Therefore, condition for imposing tax is that it should be in unit container as well as brand name. If something is in unit container, namely a 1 kg bag or tin, but it is not having a brand name, then also it will be chargeable to nil rate only. Therefore, condition for the 5% to be applicable is that both the container, it should be in unit container, and it should be having a brand name.
But if it is a packed food, as per the legal methodological law, you have to let up the
if it is a backed commodity, legal metrology provisions will be applicable, and then you will have to provide the declaration on that pack. Then the brand name, if it is used, then it will be liable to tax. So once you pack, then you will be in trouble. Yes. The next. Then we are on the input side of the poultry sector, which is the animal feed. There is a vexed question as to whether a product is animal feed or it is additive only, not animal feed, and therefore whether animal feed will include animal feed supplement, the additives for animal feed, whether it will be liable to tax. These are already both in excise, central excise, as well as VAT. The questions were raised. In VAT, this is the form in which VAT always was aquatic feed, including shrimp feed and prawn feed, poultry feed and cattle feed, including grass, hay, straw, supplement and husk of pulse, concentrates and additives, wheat, bran and de-oiled cake. This was the exemption was given. This I will come to later on, that de-oiled cake where it is of soya bean, what will happen? These are exempt, chargeable to nail.